Today, we will go from day render to night render. It's a great idea when you don't have a large portfolio and you want to showcase different sceneries. This video is brought to you by Glow Plants. Give them some love in the comments. Here is the finished image from my advanced exterior course. The link in the corner if you are interested. My main lights are the Corona Sky and the Corona Sun. By the way, the steps are exactly the same in V-Ray, so don't ask me in the comments to do it in V-Ray as well, just use V-Ray Sky and V-Ray Sun instead. The great thing about Lightimix is that we can quickly change the values after the render is finished. I will turn off all the layers except the sky and the sun and start adjusting them. I will start with the sky. I will change the color to blue. Of course, we have to lower the intensity as well. There is an issue here. The sky looks like the sun is down on the horizon, which it is actually. The sky is generated based on the sun position and we don't want that, as we will be turning the sun into the moon. If I change the color of the sun to blue, it gets greenish. Similar problem here. Sun color is automatically adjusted based on the position to give the most realistic result. Let me show you how to fix this. Select the sun and go to settings. Obviously, the sun is not visible during the nighttime, but we'll use it as the moon. We used realistic sun mode, which already uses color based on the position, in this case orange, as it's sunset. That's why when we change color to blue, it's become greenish. We have to switch it to the direct input. And now we can adjust the color just in the light mix. I will lower the intensity a lot. Make sure you can still see the foreground and the palms, which look gorgeous. By the way, did you know that all the palms in the background are made just from the one glow plants model? I will put a link to the video tutorial in the corner, which doesn't have a lot of views in comparison to other videos I have made, which is weird in my opinion, as it's a really useful trick, so make sure you check it out. Here, you can notice that the shadows are really sharp. It's not realistic. To make them softer, we have to make the light bigger. I like that. There is one issue though. You can see that the volumetric pass uses the values from the settings, not from the light mix. We need to take the values from light mix to the settings. With the sun it's easy. Just use this value in the intensity and copy the color. Now we just have to reset the light mix value to 1 and the color to white. As I mentioned before, all the trees and vegetation we use come from glow plants. Glow plant models are not only very detailed and photorealistic, but also have really well done materials, which is even more important. You can buy individual models or bundles. It's very convenient. Let's say you work on a project like this. Just choose this bundle and you have all these different palms to choose from. They create exact plant species. The palms I use in the background are called Washingtonia robusta. You get not only these models, but also different growth stages. If you cannot find the model you need, don't worry, just email them and they will custom make it for you. The link in the corner if you are interested. Great, now let's fix the sky. We need to take the map from the environmental slot and place it in the material editor as an instance. Then, we just have to change the model from PRG to Rava Fake. Great, look more like night now. We have to of course lower the opacity. I will reset the color to white and adjust it in the settings so it appears correctly on the volumetric pass. We have to adjust the horizon color. Same with the intensity. Change it to 1 in the light mix and to 0.1 in the material editor. Now, it looks well in the pass. I will actually make the sky even darker. Great, next, let's find the place for the moon. I will try behind the building first. Here could be a nice spot, but I don't want to have it close to the interior lights. I will move it to the right-hand side, where it will balance the composition nicely. I think it works way better here. I will move it slightly up and to the left. I will disable the visibility as it doesn't look good. Make sure you stay till the end, I will show you how to add gray looking moon in Photoshop. I like this position because it creates nice reflections in the foreground. We also have to adjust assets and work on storytelling. Before, I had this couple walking toward the building, but they don't work here anymore. I will remove them as well as a couple of people from the lunches. Wow, what happened here? I will also add fog in the foreground from the ocean to add a mysterious mood. If you want to learn how to create fog, I will put the link to my tutorial in the corner. Lastly, let's adjust the other lights. Here it's super simple, we just have to adjust the intensity of the lights. I will move the values from Lightimix to settings again, so the passes are correct. I will reset the Lightimix value to 1 and multiply the light value by 100. We need to adjust just one light because they are instances. I will use the same color and add 2 zeros to the intensity. Here it is, looks the same, but the passes are correct. Now we can slightly adjust it in the Lightimix without changing settings, as long as this is not as drastic as before. It's a good idea to also add other lights from scratch. I will place some in the jungle close to the houses. If you work on street visualization, for example, add some lights to the street lamps and buildings in the neighborhood. Let me show you just the rest layer. Looking good, I will add a couple more of these lights. I will add one to the right-hand side of the building as well, as it's super dark out there. Awesome! Always done in 3D. Now let's jump to Photoshop. Here, it is the finished render. I've done the color correction already, just the basic stuff. I have the original image in the background and the same image with a mask out sky on top of it. By the way, you can download this Photoshop file with stars and moon, I will show you later to practice from my website. Link in the corner and description below the video. The first thing I will do here is I will make the sky way darker. I will use levels. It looks weird, we have to make it out from the lower part of the sky. I will use a gradient from white to black. Way better. I will mask it out a bit more using a black brush. Great, now let's add stars. You'll find this image in the PSD file. I will place it on top of the level layer and adjust the scale. I will add level to it as well. We need to make the sky black so it would brighten up our sky. Change the mode to screen so only stars are visible. Here's why we had to add levels. I will add a mask and use a similar gradient as before to mask them out from the lower part of the sky. I will use a brush to adjust the mask a bit more. I'm happy with that. Now let's add the moon. You'll find this image as well in the PSD file. I will select the moon and copy it to the file. Let's move it on top of everything else. I will scale it down and position it in the correct place. It's not finished. We can do way better than that. I will convert the moon into a smart object. We need to blur it a bit, so it's not too sharp. Just a tiny bit. I will duplicate it and make the blur way larger. This way, we have a nice glow. I will duplicate it again. This time, I will decrease the blur so we have a gradient. Here is the before and after. Now let's copy this layer on top. I will change the mode to screen. It will brighten up the moon. I will adjust the blur. The smaller the blur, the more noticeable the effect. Around 50 looks well. I will decrease the opacity a bit though. I will group it all together and add a curve adjustment layer to match the color. I will desaturate it a bit as well. Great, let's locate the main image. Here it is. I will add a black mask so the whole image is not visible. And I will paint with a white brush over it, so we have a large gradient on the edge. Look at that, looking way better. Lastly, we can decrease the opacity of the whole group, so the moon looks like it's behind the fog. We have to remember to mask out the stars behind the moon though. And here it is, with just a few simple steps, we went from day to night. If you want to learn how to create amazing exterior visualization like this one, check out my advanced online course. Also, watch other free tutorials here on YouTube. These are my picks. Bye-bye!